Has Jamie Foxx been cloned? Was he about to expose Diddy's secret? Is this the video that caused Jamie Foxx to be in the hospital?
Down car with a camera, say, yo, Puff, yo, you gotta let me film this, the whole thing. We need to document this, Playboy. He was like, yep.
Or was Tom Cruise still upset that Jamie Foxx was dating Katie Holmes, his ex-wife? Have you guys heard about these naked basketball parties that Jamie Foxx allegedly throws at his house?
What the f- is going on?
Instead of focusing on Jamie Foxx's progress and how he's doing and his well-being, we've been focused on all the conspiracies and rumors that we've heard about Jamie Foxx throughout the years. So let's go ahead and put it on the table and talk about it. Make sure you guys sign up for the Money Consciousness Masterclass. The link will be in the description of this video. On April 12, 2023, Corinne Fox stated that her father, Jamie Fox, had a medical complication during a procedure. Then she let us know, due to their quick action, Jamie Fox was actually already on the road to recovery. We were a little leery of what was going on, but we were fine with this information. As I told you guys before in a previous video, she was trying to get ahead of the story because allegedly TMZ was going to report that Jamie had some kind of complication or something went wrong, so she went ahead and told everybody before the story got leaked out by the press. We got suspicious 8 days later because the movie that Jamie Foxx was working on with Netflix, they continued without him and used a body double. So we're like, if Jamie is all right and he's recovering, why do you need a body double? Couldn't they just wait for him to come back? Then more weeks went by with no update from the Fox family, and that's when the media went crazy. Fox was reported as not doing well. Even some blogs and media were even saying that he was on life support. Family had to be called in because it was not looking like he was going to be able to make it. It was a very scary situation. We were all worried about Jamie Fox. It didn't help that his friends and other celebrities were asking us to pray for Jamie. And it wasn't just say, hey, pray for my friend and hope that he's recovering well. It was more like, this is a dire situation and we all need to get down and pray for this man. Y'all know the difference between the two.
I mean, yeah.
And while Jamie was in the hospital, he allegedly posted this: appreciate all the love, feeling blessed. However, none of us believe Jamie Foxx wrote this. Finally, on May 12th, 1 month after Jamie Foxx was initially reported to being in the hospital, Corinne Fox stated that he has been out of the hospital for weeks and he was now recovering. And she said he was even playing pickleball. So we got a few questions at this point. Wasn't he just in the hospital? When did he go to rehab or when did he go back home? And lastly, what the hell is pickleball? Then TMZ reported that Jamie Foxx is in the best rehab center in Chicago and also released paparazzi photos of his oldest daughter, Corinne, and youngest daughter. Yes, the facility does have pickleball there. Now that Jamie Foxx, or his clone, seems to be okay, let's go ahead and talk about some of the conspiracy theories. And I just want to say one thing. When we should be concerned about the man's health, we are concerned about the wrong things at the same time. One thing being Diddy set up Jamie Foxx because Jamie Foxx allegedly exposed Diddy for having these crazy sex parties and was going to out him. That has been circulating around TikTok, has been out for years, and Jamie Foxx did not expose Diddy. He was just talking about how he's seen other famous people at the party. He did not give any details about anything crazy, anything illegal, or any Illuminati stuff going on. Jamie Foxx has talked about Diddy and his parties for years. He went on the Stephen Colbert show. He went on the Joe Rogan podcast. I'll go ahead and play the audio, as for legal reasons, I can't play the actual video. Let's get into it.
I followed Diddy back in the day when Diddy had all of the songs out. Yeah. He was so famous, we couldn't get into our own clubs in L.A. Like, we go in the club, you'll get...
Well, like, you go with him?
No, he would come from New York to L.A.
I see.
And I couldn't even get in the club because he was so famous. And not right now, Fox, Diddy in here. So one day I flipped it on him and showed up in a town. It was town car days. I had a town car. Popped out the town car with a camera. Said, yo, Puff, yo, you got to let me film this, the whole thing. We need to document this, Playboy. He was like, yo, let him through. And I'm like, all right, I'm through. And I had the big Canon camera. It wasn't like this.
Sure, yeah.
You know, so I had the big Canon camera with the light and the battery. Yo, do that again, Puff. And so I started hanging out with Puff, like, back in the day, and I know this story don't make sense, but it's gonna make sense. I would hang out and watch him throw parties.
Sure, he famously threw his white party out.
Well, he would throw a party. One point, I went to Philly, followed him all the way to Philly. He threw a party, and he said, yo, Playboy, this party costs $1.5 million.
To throw?
I'm like, you are out of your mind. And I said, Puff, I'll throw you a party for 400 bucks. That will rival this party. Mm-hmm. And he got pissed at me. He said, yo, don't play with me. I'm your ham. I'm Diddy. You know what I'm saying? I said, no, I'm not. I respect you.
And the same story on the Joe Rogan podcast, which you can see here. All these clips are on YouTube.
And he shows up. And when he shows up, he goes, that's the girl on that TV show. Oh, that's the girl in the movie. I said, yeah, we're friends. He's like, we all hang out here. So it's like, you know, it's all good. And that's the girl. I said, yeah, yeah. I said, but look at the party. I said, look over there on the table. I got Kentucky Fried Chicken, but I put it in a nice plate. I got Coca-Cola, but it's just in a pitcher. I said, we're at $280 right now and counting. I won't go over 400. And he had the most incredible time.
One, him and Diddy are friends. Two, Diddy did not have anybody poison him. And especially if they're friends, why would he have somebody poison him? And three, those stories that he was talking about Diddy, it didn't expose anything. Trust me, you know what they said. If you invited to the Illuminati or you go to one of those parties, you ain't supposed to say nothing. You supposed to be quiet. Shh. Or not Jamie Foxx be playing naked basketball with his friends or whatnot. Hey, as long as it's consenting adults, it's none of our business, and that has nothing to do with why he's in the hospital. So let's go ahead and move on from that. Now you're probably asking, so did Tom Cruise do something to Jamie Foxx? I don't know, but that's one of the conspiracies. Let's go ahead and talk about it. So as you guys know, Katie Holmes and Jamie Foxx have been dating since 2013. They had kind of kept it quiet until 2019 when they went public. They allegedly had a 6-year on-again, off-again relationship with each other. Now we know Tom Cruise and Jamie Foxx did the movie Collateral together in 2004, and they have been friends since then. Katie and Tom started dating the following year and eventually got married. They were together for almost 6 years and ended up divorcing in 2012. It was said while they were going through their divorce, Tom Cruise actually hired a private investigator. The investigator found out that Katie and Jamie were seeing each other when they were still married. Mind you, Jamie Foxx is his friend. So yes, this seems like the ultimate betrayal. In the Church of Scientology, they really don't like divorces. And once you get divorced, you're basically done. So Katie wanted to get out of there. She went ahead and got sole custody of her daughter so she could remove her from that Scientology school in California. It's also said Tom has not had any communication with his daughter, Suri, since the divorce. That's crazy to me. Why would the Church of Scientology want to hurt Jamie Foxx? It was said that maybe Katie Holmes might have shared some information with Jamie Foxx about the church that she was not supposed to share. And so because they did not want this information out, this is why they did. And again, I don't know what they did, but they did whatever to Jamie to cause him to go to the hospital. Since Holmes and Foxx were dating, Tom Cruise never came out publicly and said anything about their relationship. But as we know, and it's been reported, him and Jamie Foxx are no longer friends. The conspiracy about the church and Tom Cruise is interesting because they actually stopped dating, talking about Katie and Jamie, in 2019. So why would they wait until now to do something to them? Or did they want to play it off and make it look like something else? Now, when we go through things, we get to go through them privately. However, Jamie is a public figure, so everybody's going to be in his business and everybody wants to know. I think this was a situation where Corinne was trying to get ahead of the story and she probably shouldn't have said anything because it left us with more questions and it left also the media to fill in the blanks and create their own conspiracies on what actually happened. Like I've been saying, you guys, I am a fan of Jamie Foxx. No matter how you feel about the situation, please just continue to pray for him. We wish him the best and hope he comes back 100%. Make sure you guys leave your thoughts and opinions down below. All right, we out, y'all. Deuces.